My name is Rahul, I'm studying medicine and I've just completed the secondary care attachment for psychiatry. I really enjoyed psychiatry. I think perhaps it sort of matched my personality type, or perhaps I'm just not very good at everything else, but I did enjoy sort of the teaching and also sort of going in and seeing the patients. I think one element of course is sort of personal experience. I mean, we've all seen or experienced ourselves mental health difficulties, so it was interesting to see that and understand a bit more about it. And partly I think for me it was just seeing the consultants on the wards and just the tireless work of all the staff, you know, nurses, community support workers, and I think for me that showed that for psychiatry there's this sort of massive energy still there to help the patient. And I suppose I was drawn to that, a bit like a moth to the flame, that it was just something I wanted to do and something I saw most in psychiatry. So I suppose it follows the normal structure for a module. We have about a couple of months of lectures where you learn the theory. You do get to see patients in primary care, but predominantly knowledge. And then in secondary care was seeing the patients. So I saw acute psychiatry. These were people who were acutely unwell. And then old age psychiatry, so people with the first symptoms of dementia and so on. And I think overall that really, that secondary care attachment not only consolidated my knowledge, but convinced me that what was initially an interest also developed into sort of an attitude, now a passion for psychiatry. So we were dotted around Norfolk and Suffolk Foundation Trust. So for example, I was for a week in an acute psychiatric unit. It was a secure facility, so we'd be sort of shadowing psychiatrists, but the patients would be actively unwell. Then we were also doing sort of house calls, going and visiting lovely old ladies in the Norfolk countryside who were sort of exhibiting the first symptoms of dementia, so that was more an assessment element of that. And then just generally sitting in on meetings between different psychiatric professionals to see how do you dissect a patient case and how do you translate that into management. So it really was a mixed bunch compared to a lot of other specialties where you tend to stay on one ward for a month. This was a really holistic experience. I think UEA is really at the forefront of medical education, and it's mainly because of the clinical aspects. A lot of previous medical education has been about learning about the theory and then expecting you to be able to relate that to a patient. UEA firstly offers you the idea to bring the knowledge you have and apply it to the patients that you meet, but then also to practice your communication skills. From, I think I was in week one, we were already learning how to talk to patients, which was overwhelming to be honest, but at the same time, I'm glad we did, because now I feel a lot more confident talking to patients than I would if I'd only just started speaking today. So I think really in terms of communication, UEA holds that dear, and I'm really glad they do, because that will prepare doctors for the future more so than sitting in a library.